Welcome to our 2020 Veterans Day celebration. Please stand for the pledge led by our third grade students, Carter, Caleb, and Callie, followed by the national anthem performed by Catherine.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night. That our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the
I'm Kay, an 8th grade student here at Leonberg. On behalf of the Mighty Lions, I want to thank you for watching this video and honoring the wonderful veterans of our community. Although this year's celebration looks different than it has in years past, one thing remains the same: our commitment to honoring veterans. Veterans Day may only come once a year, but it is the hope of our students and staff that all veterans feel our love, respect, and thankfulness every day of the year. LES has been working especially hard to prepare this video and hope you will enjoy. We appreciate the sacrifices that you have made on behalf of our great nation. With that being said, please enjoy the video.
Hello, Leonville Elementary School. My name is Patrick Jenkins, Superintendent, St. Ledger Parish Schools, and also a military veteran. First, I would like to say Happy Veterans Day. I've been asked to answer a few questions for you today, and hopefully I do a great job at them. Before I get started with the questions, I want to give you a little bit of history. I'm a retired Army officer, serving 22 years in the Army Reserve and National Guard. In addition to that, I worked as an engineer officer for most of my career. The first question that I was asked is, what made you to decide to serve in our military? Well, I have a history in my family of military service. Cousins, uncles, brothers serving in the military goes far back as the Korean War. And so I wanted to be a part of that fraternity. In addition to that, it allowed me to go to college and graduate school and also pass those benefits along to my children as well for them to go to school. The second question that was asked of me is, what is your happiest memory from your time in the service? I had so many happy memories of just serving along with my brothers in the military and training with them and forming bonds. But perhaps one of my happiest memories of while serving in Afghanistan is leaving Afghanistan on the 4th of July, 2003 or 2003. That was a great memory and one of the best 4th of Julys I ever had. I did serve in Iraq and Afghanistan. Lastly, the last question is, what is the most important thing you learned while serving in the military? Well, the military has some Army values, and they are loyalty, duty, respect, selfless service, honor, integrity, and personal courage. I believe these values should all people should have, and I carry with them with me every single day.
Veterans Day is a very special day in the United States. It is a day our nation salutes the men and women who have defended our country by serving in the military. This is a special day set aside to honor all of the men and women who have served our country and is celebrated on November 11th each year. This holiday was first known as Armistice Day, but our elected leaders wanted to make sure that it was a day where all veterans were honored. So in 1954, Congress passed a bill to change the name from Armistice Day to Veterans Day. There are many different kinds of Veterans Day ceremonies held all over America. Many communities, schools, churches, and other groups have parades, assemblies, special recognition events, and other tributes to honor America's veterans on this day. It is important to remember that although it is a special day, originated as a tribute to those who sacrificed their lives in World War I, it also honors all of who have served before or after World War I to defend our way of life. From the veterans of the American Revolution who helped establish our great country to modern day veterans fighting the war on terrorism, we honor them all on Veterans Day.
Hey there, Leonville. I'm Senior Airman Kyle LeBlanc. I'm the son of Matt and Holly LeBlanc, one of the teachers at your school. I just wanted to stop and take a moment to thank everybody for their support. It really means a lot, especially to us who are deployed out of country. And I also want to take another moment to thank all veterans who may be watching this for your pride and dedication and service to the greatest country in the world. Thank you. Have a good one.
Hi, I'm Chief Warrant Officer 2 Brandy Camara from Karankura, Louisiana, currently stationed in beautiful Hawaii. Some of the most happiest moments of my military career have been to travel across the world, meet people from all walks of life, and work together as a team to accomplish anything. Another one of my most happiest moments of my military service has been, since I have been stationed so far away from home, is to be reunited with my family in South Louisiana, and also the food. Eat crawfish, boudin, gumbo, some of my favorite foods, but overall just being reunited with my family since being so far away. I would like to thank all of my brothers and sisters in arms, past, present, for their military service, and happy Veterans Day.
Hi, my name is Captain Martina Moore, and I'm a native of Opelousas, Louisiana. I joined the Army at the age of 18, and I've been serving for 17 years as a human resources officer. The happiest memory in the Army is the day that I graduated basic combat training. This was significant because it was the start of my military career. It instilled me with the discipline and the confidence needed to take on many life challenges. It made me proud, and most of all, it made my family proud.
Thank you. So the most important thing I learned during my service is that my mom can't really help me. I had to grow up real fast. I came straight out of high school. I was 18 years old. And I couldn't do anything right. I remember in boot camp, I got yelled at a lot for not doing anything right. And I was like, I wanted them to hold my hand. And they were like, well, again, you got to pull your weight. And so I had to learn real quick that I had to pull my own weight and had to take responsibility for myself. And that's the most important thing I learned from my service in the military.
B is for victorious.
E is for excellent.
T is for tough.
E is for extraordinary.
R is for strength. A is for honor.
N is for nation's hero.
S is for service to our country.
Thank you, guys!
I joined the military to learn a skill set that I could use with my family and my community. I joined the military as a Medical Service Corps officer, and now I have the skills to help out my family and help out my community. That is why I serve.
Hello class, my name is Captain Tremaine Moore and I am a native of Appaloosas, Louisiana. I've been in the Army for the past 11 years and I'm a logistician officer. So what did I learn in the past of being in the military? I would say the most thing I absolutely learned is about people and the diversity of people. We come from all different states and international countries. So I've been blessed to work with multiple nationalities that brings us together and help us secure our country in the best way possible.
I'm Emily from the class, second grade.
Veterans help others.
Veterans work to defend peace.
Veterans show bravery.
Veterans keep us safe and protect us.
Moment as a Marine?
When I graduated boot camp, knowing that I would be a Marine for the rest of my life.
Okay.
Hi, my name is Rashimia Collins. I was in the Louisiana National Guard for 9 years. I served from 2009 to 2018. The reason why I joined the military was to go to college tuition-free, 100% tuition-free, is something that the National Guard offers to you, specifically the Louisiana National Guard. I also wanted to serve my country. Being a Guard's member, I was able to do both. I was able to be a citizen and a soldier. In those 9 years, I learned so much. I got to meet so many people. And it helped me turn into the person I am today. I wouldn't regret my decision in going into the military or even ultimately getting out. So that's it really for this video.
We hope that you've enjoyed the video. As is our yearly tradition, we wish to put the faces to the names of the brave men and women that we call veterans. Many of you have family and friends who are either currently serving in our armed forces or who have served in the past. We now present our slideshow to honor these brave men and women, followed by a message from Dr. Morrison.
Smoking fire, I didn't feel a thing. But suddenly I was rising higher, and I felt like I just made the biggest mistake. When I thought about my unborn child, when I thought about my wife, and the answer rang out clear from somewhere up above. No greater gift has man than to lay down his life for love. And I wonder, would I give my life? Or could I make that sacrifice? If I came down to it, could I take the blue? Yes, I would. I don't understand it all myself. But there's a brother on my left and another on my right, and in his pocket just like mine, he's got a photograph, and they're waiting for him back home. And it's weighing on my mind. I'm not trying to be a hero, I don't wanna die. But right now in this moment, you don't think twice. I wonder, would I give my life? Could I make that sacrifice? If I came down to it, could I take the blue? Yes, I would.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston and New York to LA, well, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, proud to be an American.
Most Americans profess their love for our veterans, especially during times like this, Veterans Day celebrations. And while their feelings are usually sincere, it is important to remember that veterans are defending our country 365 days a year. That heroism that has been demonstrated time and time again by veterans from the American Revolution to the global war on terrorism is sometimes unnoticed by those of us who enjoy the security that their sacrifice has provided. Our debt to these heroes can never be repaid, but our gratitude and respect must last forever. For many veterans, our nation was important enough to endure long separations from their families, miss the births of their children, freeze in sub-zero temperatures, bake in wild jungles, lose limbs, and far too often lose their lives. Military spouses have had to endure career interruptions and frequent changes of address. The children often had to deal with changes in school, separation from friends, and the hardest of all, the uncertainty of mom or dad's safety. At this time, I would like to thank Mrs. Barron and her committee for the amazing job they did in organizing this event, especially during this time with COVID, when we are unable to meet in an assembly like we normally do. I would also like to thank the faculty, staff, and students for assisting in bringing this vision to life. Veterans have given us freedom, security, and the greatest nation on earth. It is impossible to put a price on that. We must remember them. We must appreciate them. God bless you. God bless our veterans, and God bless America. Thank you.